This is a motherboard from China. This is an AM5 ITX motherboard that cost me only 115 Canadian rubles. Shipping cost was 40, so overall I've acquired this for $155. Do you know how cheap this is for an AM5 ITX motherboard? A similar ASRock B650 ITX motherboard cost me $300, tax and shipping included. This is JGINYUE B650 ITX motherboard. It comes with the nickname Night Devil. This motherboard has been out for a while, but I haven't really had the desire to import this until motherboard prices started to skyrocket in recent years for no apparent reason. Given that its total cost was about half of what I would need to pay normally, the deal felt too good to pass up. I see. Well, this is one way to reduce the price. Apparently, you need to install your own Wi-Fi card. I don't have a spare Wi-Fi card at the moment. Therefore, I will do another video on this at a later date. A Wi-Fi card could be optional for some people, so I can see why they opted to omit it. The only issue I see here is that it is not exactly easy to install this if you don't have proper screwdrivers. The motherboard looks normal. I mean, I am not seeing any, how should I call it, cheapness found on some Chinese motherboard. In fact, this looks high-end. Again, I would like to remind you that this motherboard cost me only 115 Canadian dollars. It looks like it has diagnostic LEDs. A nice touch. I was actually becoming concerned as I saw the motherboard kept on turning on and off. I suppose it was DDR5 RAM training, but that was a weird way to do it. All right. Everything looks good. I am very pleased that this motherboard exceeded my expectations. It has two M.2 slots, diagnostic LEDs, reinforced PCIe Express slot, built-in I/O shield, two ARGB headers, etc. It has almost everything you could find on a high-end motherboard. Yes, it is missing a Wi-Fi card, but they provide you the housing. An Intel Wi-Fi card costs around $25. Again, Canadian rubles. I personally don't need one since I use an unmanaged switch to provide wired internet to my rack-mounted computers. So I don't mind that they omitted not to include it. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe.